Hi guys, it's Becca here from Trent Kids with your Friday catch-up. And we have now had 6 weeks of lockdown, which is such a long time. And although I'm really missing my family and friends, I'm so glad that I'm safe and that people are coming together and helping each other out. Today is VE Day, and so I'm thinking about how people went to war and to fight for our country, and how thankful I am that we are no longer at war. So today is a celebration of that, and I hope that you're having a little party in your own way. This week, James set our Monday challenge to write our own worship song. What a brilliant challenge, because he was asking us to think about things that we can thank God for. And even if you're not musical like me, that means that we can all get involved because we all have things to be thankful for. So I was thinking, what would be on my list? And I'm thankful for my family and my friends, for my cozy bed, for my garden and all the flowers. And I'm thankful that Jesus is looking after me. So I'm hoping that you can think of some things too and get those sent in. We are working hard to put all these ideas together, but we still have another week. So if you haven't already done the challenge, then you've still got time to send in your ideas and your videos. Today, we have got Amy from Trent Kids, who's gonna do our devotional for us. Let's see Amy.
Hello, my name's Amy and I'm gonna be teaching a bit about Jesus. Here is a Bible verse. It's from Romans 3:23-24. As everyone had sins, we all fall short of God's glorious standard, yet God with undeserved kindness declares that we are righteous. He did this through Christ Jesus, and he freed us from penalty from our sins. Have you ever met someone who seems to be perfect in every way? Perfect grades, perfect clothes, perfect family. It doesn't seem fair, does it? How come she and her life are perfect and you and your life aren't? Truth is no one, and nothing is perfect except God. Some people in their lives might seem that way, but they're really not. And it's because people are not perfect. We need God so much. So don't let your flaws and your mess ups keep you from realising that you're all God wants you to be. After all, he does expect you to be perfect. What a relief, right? So does that mean you should keep your aiming for excellence? Of course not. God wants you to do the best you can. But remember that even when you mess up and you will, you can run back to him and ask for forgiveness and guidance. He'll forgive all of your sins and whisper, I love you, precious girl or boy. Now walk this way. Dear Lord, thank you for not expecting me to be perfect. Helps me to know you will always love me in spite of my mess up. And now try if you like a little challenge. Try drawing a picture to do with Easter from the Bible for a super challenge. Try drawing it with your eyes closed and to get a grown-up to guess what it is. Bye for now!
It is so good that God is perfect and that he can forgive us when we get things wrong. Thank you, Amy, for reminding us of that. Guys, I hope that you have the best week and don't forget to send in your song ideas, and I'll see you again for next week's challenge. Bye.